This is the complete, unedited start to finish of that. Take a look.
You say that you were hacked, which is potentially a crime. So why haven't you asked the Capitol Police or any law enforcement to investigate?
Look, this was a prank that I've now been talking about for a couple of days. I'm not going to allow it to decide what I talk about for the next week or the next 2 weeks. And so I'm not going to be giving anything more about that today. I think I've been pretty responsive to you in the past.
But with respect, you're here, which we appreciate, but you're not answering the questions. Can you just say why you haven't asked law enforcement to investigate what you are alleging is a crime?
You know, Dana, if I was giving a speech to 45,000 people, and someone in the back of the room threw a pie or yelled out an insult, would I spend the next 2 hours responding to that? No. I would get back. Well, why don't you do what? You want to do the briefing?
Do you want to do
the briefing, sir?
From your Twitter account,
sir.
A lewd photograph was sent to a college student.
Sir.
Answer the question. Was it from you or
sir.
Not?
Permit me. Do you guys want me to finish my answer?
Yes. This
answer.
Did you send it or not?
If I were giving a speech to 45,000 people and someone in the back threw a pie or yelled out an insult, I would not spend the next 2 hours of my speech responding to that pie or that insult. I would return to the things that I want to talk about, to the audience that I wanted to
talk
to.
All you have to do is say no.
And that is what I intend to do this week.
Let me try this question. The woman who allegedly got this tweet, or was directed to, a 21-year-old college student in Seattle, she released a statement to the New York Daily News yesterday saying that you follow her on Twitter. Is that true? Did you follow her on Twitter? And if so, how did you find her? What was the reason?
You know, I have, I think, said this a couple of ways, and I'll say it again. I am not going to permit myself to be distracted by this issue any longer.
All you have to do is say no to that question.
You are free. You're very good at...
If you're not following her on Twitter.
Why don't you let me do the answers and you do the questions?
As soon as you answer the question sir, we will.
I'm with you, buddy. I'm with you.
You follow an awful lot of young women on Twitter. Is there a reason that you have so many ladies that you're following on?
By the way, in related news, I have in the famous hashtag Scrappy Chasing Crazy, I passed Michelle Bachmann today, the number of Twitter followers. I will give you that additional fact.
Is that a result of this?
And unfortunately, it probably is.
Congressman, you understand what's going on here, the frustration. We appreciate you coming out and you're talking to us.
Sure.
You're smiling, you're cooperating, and that gives, you know, good optics, but you're not answering the question. So can you answer
this is
even
now,
the most basic question?
This is now day, this is now day, this
question.
Is now day three. You have statements that my office has put out.
But they don't answer the questions.
There are statements that my office has put out. And there are going to be people who are going to want, look, this is the tactic. The guy in the back of the room who's throwing the pie or yelling out the insult wants that to be the conversation.
But you are
Dana, let me,
you were hacked.
I'm going to have to ask that we follow some rules here. And one of them is going to be U.S. questions. I do the answers. That seems reasonable.
I'd love to get an answer.
That would be reasonable, right?
Direct.
You do the questions. That would be reasonable. You do the questions. I do the answers, and this jackass interrupts me. How about that as the new rule of the game?
Congressman.
Let me just give the answer. The objective of the person who is doing the mischief is to try to distract me from what I'm doing. So for the last couple of days that has happened, I've made a decision. I'm not going to let it happen today. I'm not going to let it happen tomorrow. You're free. You're doing your job. I understand it. Just go ahead and do it, but you're going to have to do it without me every day answering more questions about this. Today I want to talk about the debt limit vote. This debt limit vote tonight is very important.
Let me make a point about the debt limit. Is it because you don't want them to find out what the answer is?
Let me make a point about the debt limit. You know, we are tonight at 6:30, 6:45, going to be casting a vote on something that has monumental importance to our economy, whether or not we have a stunt vote on something as important as the debt limit. I want to focus what I talk about on that. I want to focus what I'm working on that. I want to focus on that because, frankly, I think my constituents want me to, and I think that, frankly, the country would want me to. So that's what I'm going to do. You don't have to. You can continue doing whatever you want to do. But I am not going to allow this thing to dominate what I talk about any further.
And we appreciate that. We're covering that story.
I'm glad you are.
But you understand that in the statements that you put out, you have said that you were hacked. And so it's sort of a logical question that we really wish that you would answer. Why, if you think
I
that
have
you were
you,
the victim of a
you've
crime,
you've got to refer to my
not
statements.
Ask.
You've got to refer to my statements.
The statement doesn't answer the question. If they did, we would be happy to.
I don't
the statements don't answer
look,
the question.
All I can tell you is I put out statements the last couple of days responding to everyone saying this is the last question we're going to ask. And in fact, it's pretty clear that by your presence here, some people have been successful in making the conversation about something I simply choose not to participate in anymore. You can feel free to still cover it, and you can feel free to stay here and ask me again. But you know, we have a situation where across the way is a Supreme Court that Justice Clarence Thomas, his household, received over $800,000 of remuneration from people that are trying to overturn the health care law, trying to stop it, and yet he's refusing to recuse himself. I think that's pretty important. I think that's a pretty important thing that I'm going to devote my energies to, and that those are the things I'm going
to
talk about.
And we have 24 hours, and we can do it all, but we just want to get the answer to this question.
Sure. You did say that you did retain a lawyer, so what are you directing your attorney to do on your behalf? Ask for an investigation?
We aren't going to. I think the statement speaks to that. It says they are going to advise us on appropriate next steps.
They're going to.
No, no, that's not right. It doesn't say that. So I would refer you back to the statement and read it in its entirety.
Who is the attorney?
I appreciate. Are there any other questions?
Why are you following so many people on Twitter?
That doesn't sound like another question. Look, there are people who are going to want to try to distract from the work that I have to do. There are. There are going to be people who are going to want to have this debate. And to some degree, the people that are engaging it are zealous to do it. Why? But I don't want to. I choose to fight for the things that I care about and the things that I'm working on. Look, can I tell you, I know this is how the game is played. Some people decide they want to talk about this thing for days and days. I choose not to. That's my prerogative. I'm sorry.
Can I just throw this out there, though? If this is the non-story that you say this is, and a distraction.
I didn't characterize it as a distraction. Okay. I'll leave it to you to make the decision whether
this
it's
is just a distraction. You're a sophisticated guy. Why not just answer the questions and then you'll be done with it?
I've been doing that for several days. Now I choose. Now I choose. Now I choose. I've been. There are people who apparently haven't read the statements. I assume that you have. Look, all I can tell you is this. This is akin to someone deciding on day three or day four they want to continue talking about something that I consider a distraction, and me making a decision on how I'm going to deal with this. And the decision that I've made is I'm not going to permit it to distract me. I'm not going to permit it to continue on for 3, 4, 5, or 6 more days. If that's unsatisfactory to you, I apologize. But I think that what people really want to talk about are things like the debt limit vote tonight, are things like the oppressive disparity between the very well-to-do in this country and people that don't have as much, or the fact that it's more and more difficult being in the middle class in this country. That's what I'm here to work on. Thank you, guys.
Will you vote for the debt limit tonight?
No.